Poovar has a bit of everything that you'd expect from Kerala. The backwaters, lots of coconut trees, the beach, and of course, Sadya. Hi everyone and welcome to Sugar Spice Nice. My name is Shweta and in this video I'm exploring Poovar in Kerala. Just about an hour from Thiruvananthapuram airport, Poovar is one of the most scenic places in Kerala. When in Poovar, pick a resort with a great view and good access to the beach and the backwaters. I'm staying at Estuary Sarovar Portico. You'll have different types of accommodation. There are garden view rooms, there are luxury cottages, there are villas where some of them even have an indoor pool. I'm staying at the premium cottage. So this is what the outside of a premium cottage looks like. So it's almost like a bed. I think one person can easily lie down here. Let's go inside. This is the room. This here is like a little partition between the bedroom and a little living area. A dressing room of sorts, two sinks. Here you have the cupboards. So this is the shower.
Wow,
bathtub experience. It's for two. These are all of the activities that you can do here. I like that they've actually segregated them into non-chargeable and chargeable. That there is the pool area. There are two pools. One is this one and the other one is right next to the restaurant. So now it's time for lunch and the staff here have arranged a sadya meal for me. This is my second sadya in my Kerala trip, but I can already feel that this one is going to be really, really good because one, there's jackfruit and banana chips in this. And the second thing is they actually explained to me exactly how I'm supposed to go about indulging in a sadya meal. So firstly, the meal is served on this banana leaf. When warm food falls on the banana leaf, it activates certain antioxidants, certain flavoring agents, which enhance the taste value and also the nutritive value of the food. Another thing is that the food is served in a particular order. So you're supposed to start from your right and move towards your left. One thing that sadya takes care of is ensuring that all of your taste buds are satisfied. So whether it is sour, sweet, pungent, spicy, everything will be taken care of in this meal. And every part of the sadya meal goes course by course. So the first course is served to me. This is dal, rice and ghee. The dal is known as paripu curry, crushing some papad on top. Dal, rice and papad is comfort food across any kind of Indian cuisine that you pick up. Now, all of these other things that you see on the banana leaf, they're all accompaniments, they're all condiments. So you basically keep alternating with a bite of each of these and the dal rice. So I'm getting some avial, kind of boiled vegetables along with coconut. There's raw banana, there's carrot, there's pumpkin. Good thing about avial is that you can feel the veggies. They're not completely like boiled. You can also feel the freshness of the coconut. Now this is something known as kuttu curry. It's basically chickpeas and potato in kind of like a gravy. There's coriander seeds that go in it. There's garlic, there's ginger, there's even sauf or fennel. Now these are white kidney beans. This thing is known as elisiri. Let's mix it into the dal rice. Now these two items that you see, they're known as khichdi and pachadi. So this is the beetroot khichdi. Basically beetroot that is cooked is completely pureed and then tempered with mustard, curry leaves. Here, this is cucumber pachadi. So this is cucumber that is just about boiled and then that is tempered. It's also got coconut in it. Let me try the cucumber one first. You can feel the coconut, you can feel the taste of the cucumber, but you can also feel the chili in this one. This is amazing. You know, there is so much mustard in this, and that flavor and the flavor of curry leaves is just exceptional. Now, this is something known as Madura curry. So it's basically pineapple and sugar. There's also some cashew nut paste added to this. It feels like a pineapple preserve. These two, they seem like coconut chutneys. They're known as sambal. This is toran. It's basically a dry cabbage sabzi. So this one also has urad dal. I personally love the flavor of urad. Now on a regular basis, the pickle that is served in most Kerala homes is lemon pickle. But for Sadhya, there is mango pickle. It is usually had with curd. Now this is another chutney of sorts. It's called imchi curry. This is ginger. This is all ginger. Now I've been waiting to come this side and just get some banana chips and jackfruit chips. You can see how puffed these are. One new thing that I've seen is this fried banana chips but coated with jaggery. First I thought this was just a blob of jaggery and I got really happy, but when I heard it's chips coated with jaggery, I got happier. So this is called sharkara varati. Now comes the sambar, and the sambar is filled with veggies. The sambar here is more on the sour side. Next comes pulisheri, the yogurt based curry. So it's really, really sour. And then we have some rasam. Buttermilk on the rice. Now we have payasam. This is the paripu payasam, and this is the one which has lentils inside. And this is supposed to be had with the banana. You have to crush the banana inside the payasam and have it. There's such a strong flavor of cardamom or elaiji in this payasam. It's exceptional. And it's got a little bit of sabudana in it. This is boli. This is another kind of payasam. This is called pal payasam. So this is basically sevaya. So the boli is made of besan, gram flour. So when you're finally done with the sadhya, and you wrap the banana leaf towards yourself. If you wrap it the other way, that is in the opposite direction, the person who is feeding you the meal in the restaurant or the chef or whoever in somebody's home may think that you've not enjoyed the meal. Now after sadhya, it is recommended that you take a nap because you've eaten quite a bit. It is small quantities, but it's a lot of different things. So I'm gonna go take my nap and fully see you guys in a bit. So after that delicious sadhya experience, we basically straight away woke up for dinner. And for dinner, there was this gorgeous table set up along with a nice authentic Kerala meal. And you have to see the way they put up the menu. So aesthetic, these are the starters. So this is til gur, that's what we call it in Mumbai. It's basically til or sesame laddus. And this one is also the same thing, only thing this is black til, black sesame. And we have murukku, chakli. That's what it's called here. This is something that I can't wait to gorge on. I haven't had it in the longest time. This is yellunda or sesame laddus. Next thing that I'm having is some appam. This here is a vegetable stew. Now first, let's just take a minute to appreciate the appams. They are beautifully thin and the center is beautifully fluffy. They basically poured out the stew on top. It's a coconut-based gravy and it's got a lot of veggies inside. I can see cauliflower, I can see carrot, and I can see beans. The appams are like melt in your mouth. Stew is very heavy on that coconut flavor. This is my most favorite part of the appam. I love this center soft part. Next course is here and we have idiyappams and we have a vegetable mappas. Vegetable mappas is a gravy. It's basically coconut and coriander paste and then a lot of veggies. Next course is here and this has the typical Kerala paratha, parota. You can see all of those layers. And then we have this Kerala style potato gravy. Got a lot of flavor from garlic and of course spices. It's not too spicy. Looking at it, I thought it's going to be really, really fiery, but it's not. And finally, it's time for some dessert, some sweet dish, and we have banana payasam. This one is warm, so it's feeling even better. So this ensures that I'm going to sleep brilliantly even tonight. So this morning started with an amazing breakfast, and after that now we are heading for a boat ride. This one is of course the Backwaters, and it's also got a view of the mangroves. So let's just go and experience it. There is the estuary point. So estuary is basically where the river meets the sea, and this is the Nayar River. It's meeting the Arabian Sea. That side there are all of the floating restaurants. So here there's a Jesus Christ and Mother Mary statue. There are a few houses there in the distance, and those are basically village homes. That is the last village of South Kerala. It's actually called Poovar Village. The water level here just feels so much more closer. I was absolutely not kidding when I said this is way prettier than Alappey. It is. I don't know if he's selling fresh coconut water, but that would just be amazing. After that amazing boat ride, we are here in a handloom factory. Just a little bit away from Estuary Sarovar Portico is an area called Balaramapuram, where I have come to the handloom factory. So here they're actually making uniforms. This is the first time I'm having green apple mousse, and oh boy, it is yum. Pastry is great, but I think I'm going to go back to enjoying the green apple mousse. We're now at the richest temple in the world, Sri Padmanabhaswamy Temple in Thiruvananthapuram, which is just an hour from Poovar. The Padmanabhaswamy Temple is dedicated to Lord Vishnu and is a mix of Kerala and Tamilian style architecture. The temple has a very strict dress code. Men need to wear a dhoti without a shirt, and women need to wear a long skirt or a sari. And no phones or cameras are allowed inside the temple. There are places to deposit them right outside the temple for a small fee. So after the temple visit, we felt really, really hungry, and we came at a place called Mothers Veg Plaza, and this place has more than 100 varieties of dosa. They also have a lot of local specialities. So I can see idiyappam, kadla curry and stew and stuff, but I am more intrigued about their dosas. I saw something called as Janak Janak Payal Dosa. It's a cocktail dosa. I have no clue what that means, but I'm not trying that. Mexican fajita dosa. Okay then. I asked him for his recommendation because I am thoroughly confused, and he said to try the Jini dosa. The dosa size is huge. You have to see how big this is. This is the butter masala dosa. That's all the masala inside. Where are my Jini dosa rolls? It's smelling yum. With the dosa, you get sambar and two chutneys. All of that maal inside, bits of paneer, onion, capsicum, some masala. The dosa is delicious. So cool. After having the dosa, they actually gave us two bananas here. We're heading to the beach now. The resort provides a free shuttle service. Somebody told me that these yellow coconuts are supposed to be ones with medicinal benefits. They're known as Ayurvedic coconuts, and then there are these regular green ones. And then there is this gorgeous beach view. This is such a gorgeous beach. It is also known as the Golden Sand Beach. Look how amazing. It is drizzling just a little bit, but this view is worth everything. We can't really cross this line because it's high tide. Otherwise, just look at that. So that was it from my visit to Poovar. I think of all the places that I visited in Kerala, Poovar definitely has to be my favorite. This is one of the most beautiful destinations I have ever seen. And if you ever plan a trip to Kerala, please keep Poovar in mind. It is gorgeous. Hope you enjoyed the video. Definitely press that thumbs up and subscribe to my channel and share the video with all of your friends and family to plan a trip here soon. That is it from me. I'll see you in my next destination from Kerala. Bye!